In the previous class, okay, in the previous class, we have discussed members subjected to tension only, and we have gone through the various necessary conditions for the design of such members, and then we solved one example how to design the members which are subjected to only tension. Okay, so today in the same line of action, we'll see design of members subjected to only bending moments. So such members are purely under flexure. So how to design such members? So that we will see today. So the necessary condition for this is the first is we neglect the concrete in the tension zone. So first condition is we have actually for in this problem we will be considering two cases. One is cracked section, a crack condition. And another will be uncracked section or uncracked condition. Okay, so let us first discuss the cracked condition. So in cracked condition, the following are the assumptions. So so assumptions, first assumption is we neglect the concrete portion of the concrete below neutral axis. So neglect concrete in tension zone. That means, suppose we have a rectangular section. Okay. And let this be a neutral axis. So, with this assumption, and let us say these are the reinforcing bars here. Okay, so with this assumption, this is our neutral axis. We assume that the portion of the concrete below neutral axis, which is in tension zone, that is neglected. So we neglect this part. Anything below the neutral axis, that is in tension zone. So we neglect the portion of the concrete in tension zone. That is our first assumption. Because your section is cracked. Since the section is cracked, means your concrete is cracked. So it cannot take any tension. Okay, so all the tension will be taken by the steel reinforcement. Okay, and all the compression will be taken by the concrete in the concrete above the neutral axis or concrete in the compression zone. So this is your actually compression zone, and this is in this is concrete in compression zone, and this is concrete in tension zone. Okay, and second assumption, that is compressive stress in concrete should be less than compressive stress in concrete should be less than or equal to sigma CBC. Okay, now if you remember, we have gone through the various permissible stresses in concrete and steel. So sigma CBC is a permissible stress in concrete due to bending compression. This is nothing but that is permissible stress in concrete due to bending compression. Okay, so that is our second assumption. So now if we draw the stress strain curve for this, okay, so this stress is sigma CBC, that is the permissible stress in bending compression. Okay, this fiber will be subjected to maximum bending stress under compression. Okay, so the stresses in that fiber should be limited to sigma CBC, that is permissible stress in concrete due to bending compression. And the third assumption is tensile stress in steel. Tensile stress in steel should be less than or equal to sigma ST. That is the permissible permissible tensile stress in steel. Okay, so so this should be this is the T tensile force, this is tensile force T, which should be equal to let this be AST, that is the area of the steel. So this should be the tensile stress in steel should be limited to sigma ST. So this force should be restricted to sigma ST times AST, so that the tensile stresses in steel are not exceeded. Okay, and same way the compressive stress here, let it be C. Okay, and this will be at a distance of, we know that this is K times D, where K is the neutral axis depth factor. So this will be KD by 3. Okay. So these three conditions, we neglected a portion of the concrete below the neutral axis, that is we neglect the concrete in tension zone, the compressive stress in concrete should be less than the sigma CBC, okay, that is this value, permissible stress in concrete due to bending compression, and the tensile stress in steel should be less than sigma ST. Okay, so So these are the assumptions while designing a member subjected to bending only. And here we are discussing the cracked section, cracked condition. So the various design parameters for the design of members subjected to bending for members subjected to bending moment only. Okay, so first one is your KC, that is neural axis depth vector, that is M sigma CBC divided M sigma CBC divided by M sigma CBC plus sigma ST. Okay, second is this is your neural axis depth vector. Second is your JC is equals to 1 minus KC by 3. Okay, then RC is equals to 1 by 2 sigma CBC times KC times JC. This the derivation of all this we have discussed in our earlier lectures. Okay, then AST is equals to M by sigma ST J into D, and PT balance is equal to RC upon sigma ST JC times 100. Okay, so so whenever you design the this crack for crack condition, you have to use these parameters for the design of the member. Second condition is uncracked condition. Now in uncracked condition, the assumption or the condition is the tensile stress in concrete, should be less than or equal to sigma C B T, okay, which is the permissible stress in concrete due to bending tension. Okay, so that means now in case of uncracked section, in case of uncracked section, our concrete is uncracked. So full concrete section. Now the concrete below the neutral axis can also take the this tension. So in that case, the stress distribution diagram. Let us say we have reinforcement here. Okay, now the full section is utilized, so our stresses will be up to the bottom of the beam. Okay, whereas in the cracked section, since the concrete is cracked, the stresses we calculate at the level of the steel. Okay, but here the full section is utilized because the section is uncracked. Stresses. So this should be sigma CBT, okay, and this is be sigma CBC. So the stresses at the bottom of the beam should be limited to sigma CBT. Okay, so now and in the previous lecture we have also seen for different grades, let us say for M25 grades, and let us say for M30 case, for M25 and HYST bar. So what are the various parameters that we will calculate here? And for M30 and HYST bars, we calculate here. So your k value will be 1 divided by 1 plus or see this formula, you can also transform this way. You divide this m sigma CBC, multiply and divide m sigma CBC, both numerator and denominator. So this will be 1 by 1 plus sigma ST divided by M sigma CBC. So this way also you can remember, or you can use this formula. So the value of the M for M25 grade, it was 10.98 times the sigma CBC for M25 grade, that is from the table in IS 3370, you can get that was 8.5. In our earlier lecture notes, you can find the table also. 10.98 into 8.5 plus sigma ST, that is 130. So substituting the values, you will get 0.418. Okay, and similarly, you can find the value of JC. JC is equals to 1 minus KC by 3, that is 0.418 by 3, so that will be 0.861. Okay, so if you have the grade M25 and HYSD bars, you can directly use these values. Then the value of RC will be 1 by 2 into sigma CBC. Sigma CBC is 8.5. into KC, that is 0.418, into JC, that is 0.861. So you will get it as 1.53, okay, the value of RC. And then you can find the value of PT also. This PT balance condition will be equal to RC, that is 1.53, divided by sigma ST, that is 130, into JC, that is 0.861, into 100. So this is the value of PT limit which you use in limit state method. So here it is PT balance. So it is 1.367. So for M25 grade and HYSD bar, the PT limit is 1.367%. Okay, same way for M30 grade you can find. So KC is equal to, now for this the modulo ratio is 9.33, and the value of sigma CVC is 10 divided by 9.33 into 10 plus for HYSD sigma ST is 130. So you will get as 0.418. So your JC will be 1 minus 0.418 by 3. So that is also 0.861. Your RC will be equal to 1 by 2 into, now sigma CBC is 10 into 0.418 into 0.861. So this value will be 1.8. Okay. These are the values for the M30 and HYSD grade. So PT balance is equal to 1.8 divided by 130 into 0.861 into 100. So it will be 1.608%. So this is the limiting value of the steel for M30 grade and HYSD bars using working stress philosophy. Okay, so you can present this in a tabular form also. You can find this in the book also. I have shared with you. So So this is the table. So this is the table. Okay, so for M25 grade, you can have the values of PT limit, the value of Q limit, JC and KC. Same way for M30 grade, you can have the value of KC, JC, Q limit and PT limit. Next thing, that is now in case of crack section, the section is cracked, okay? But in case of uncracked section, the section is uncracked. Let me write here. In case of crack section or crack condition, section is cracked. Okay, and in case of uncracked section, uncracked condition, section is uncracked. So if you see the stress strain diagram, so in case of cracked section, the stress strain diagram is the stress strain diagram is up to the level of the steel, the tensile stress. Whereas in case of uncracked section, this stress diagram is up to the bottom of the beam. So to have the uniformity, we will draw the this mu upon bd square versus this various pt and dy/d ratio curve for D by capital D ratio. Okay, so here in liquid deadening structures, when designed for uncracked condition, the charts are constructed by using overall depth D, because in case of cracked section, the section the we used to have the section up to this effective depth, but in case of uncracked section, the charts will be prepared for overall depth. So to compare the two, we will prepare for the overall depth only. So therefore, for the crack section also, we'll be using the overall depth only instead of using the effective depth. So to understand this, let us consider this section, and the reinforcements are placed at an effective depth small d, and the overall depth is capital D. So taking the moment about the transformed area, so it will be width times this area, moment of this area about the neutral axis. So it will be acting here. So moment of this portion, that is portion about the neutral axis, moment of portion above neutral axis, about neutral axis, will be equated to moment of portion below neutral axis, about neutral axis. That means we'll find the moment of the area or the portion above the neutral axis. So the area above the neutral axis is B into this KD. Okay. And the CG of this will be at KD by 2. So multiply by KD by 2. So this is nothing but the moment of the portion above the neutral axis, about neutral axis. So this should be equal to, now the portion below the neutral axis is neglected because it is a cracked section. So only the moment produce moment will be due to the steel. So that will be equal to m times AST times d minus KD. Okay. So this distance is see this distance is K into d, and this distance will be if d is the effective depth, then d minus KD. So the moment of this will be m times AST into K into d. Okay, so putting the value of AST here, so m times PT V into d by 100. See here we used to have the effective depth, but to have the comparative between the cracked and uncracked section, we are using the capital D here. Okay. Multiply by D minus KD. So on simplifying, you will get such expression. K square is equals to PTM by 50 into D by D times minus K. So here we are expressing this K, which is the neutral axis depth factor, in terms of K D by capital D. Okay, and further simplifying, you will get the value of K, because since it's a quadratic equation, you will get two values, and the possible value will be this value. And from that, you can find the moment of resistance. We know that moment of resistance is this. From with respect to T, it will be T times J into D. Okay, so what is T here? Sigma ST into AST. And what is JD? JD is your D minus KD by 3. So this is your lever arm factor. Lever arm. So substitute the value of AST here. So you will get this expression, sigma ST times PT into B into D by 100 into D minus KD by 3. Now you can transform this in terms of m by bd square. So m, you take d one more common here. So if you write d square here, then it will be divided by d, and this will be removed. So you can write m by bd square is equal to sigma st pt by 100 into d by d minus k by 3. So this is the expression, and if you plot it for different grade of steel, you will get such curve, and for different grade and different grade of concrete and steel, so you will get this curve. This is for M25 and HYSD bar. And similarly, this is for M30 and HYSD bar. Okay, so this is your M by BD square. This is also M by BD square. Okay, so you find the M by BD square from the given moment, and from the this section. D by section dimensions and the effective depth satisfying the cover requirements, you will for different this D by D ratio, you can get the value of PT. This is PT. Okay, so this way you can design the crack set, crack for design for the crack condition. Okay, for different grades of the concrete using this chart. Now in case of uncracked section, see, in case of uncracked section, the ball section is utilized in resisting the moment. Okay, so you can see that the top at the top fiber, the stresses are sigma CBC, that is the permissible stress in concrete due to bending compression, and at the bottom fiber it is the sigma CBT, that is the permissible stress in concrete due to bending tension. So so here again we take the moment of the portion above the neutral axis and portion below the neutral axis above neutral axis. So this is our neutral axis. Okay, so let us take the moment of the portion above the neutral axis about neutral axis. Okay, so that will be B into KD times KD by 2. Okay, that is this is centroidal distance of the portion above the neutral axis about the neutral axis, and this is the portion above the neutral axis, and this portion is the portion below the neutral axis. So in which this is the concrete portion and this is the steel portion. Okay, so here so let us say this, so this much part of the concrete area of this part, moment of this part about the neutral axis, it will be see the width is B, the width of this part is B into this depth. See, if this is KD, then this will be capital D minus KD. Okay, so B into capital D minus KD, and the CG of this will be at half the depth, so it will be KD square by 2. Okay, that is this part, B into KD square by D minus KD whole square by 2. This is the portion of the concrete, and the steel part, that is this. So that will be same as earlier, M times AST or M minus 1 AST, because now we have considered the concrete portion. So we have to deduct the portion occupied by the steel part. So it will be M minus 1 AST times D minus KD, that is this effective depth minus KD. So that will be this distance. So this should be equated to B into KD square by 2. Okay, so by substituting the value of AST, that is PT by 100 into BD, and simplifying, you will again get the value of K in terms of a quadratic equation, and solving that K, you will get this type of expression. Okay, K is equals to 100. This is for the uncracked condition, whereas the earlier one was for the crack condition. Then you can find the moment of inertia of the section. This is for the concrete portion, moment of inertia of the concrete portion, and this is moment of inertia of the steel part. Okay, see, if this is the section, you have to find the moment of inertia about the neutral axis. So this depth is KD, this is overall depth D, and this is width B. So the moment of inertia of the entire section will be B D cube by 12. This will be at the CG, so you have to transfer it up to the neutral axis. So plus this area, that is b into d into kd minus d by 2 whole square, or d by 2 minus kd whole square, both will be one and the same. So this will be the moment of inertia of the concrete part, and this will be the moment of inertia of the steel part, that is m minus 1 ast times the lever arm distance, that is d minus effective depth d. If this is the reinforcing level of the steel, so it will be d minus kd whole square. Okay, so adding the, both the two, you will get the value of Ixx of the entire section. Okay, so this is the value of the Ix for the uncracked section. So this is the moment of inertia, of uncracked section, Okay. Then, now you have you know from the bending equation. So the bending moment equation, if you remember, it is m by I is equals to sigma by y. Okay, so in here it will be m, that is the applied moment or the external moment, divided by Ixx, which is this one which we have just calculated, is equals to the permissible stress in tension, that is sigma cbt divided by the distance of the extreme fiber, that is this distance from here to bottom, because at sigma cbt the distance will be this capital D minus this kd from the top. Okay, so it will be d minus kd. Okay, that can be written as sigma cbt divided by d minus 1 minus k, and you can write it in form of m is equals to sigma cbt into I divided by d into 1 minus k. Okay, and you can write here dividing both sides by bd square. You can write here bd square, so this square and into this, so this becomes cube, so it will be bd cube. So with this formula you can plot a chart You can prepare a chart of type this. Okay. You can prepare this type of charts, which is similar to the one we prepared for the crack condition. Here it is m by bd square. Okay, this is also m by bd square. See, here we are using the capital, not the effective depth. Okay, it is not m by bd square. Okay, see, for the crack condition we can have m by bd this type of expression, but to have the uniformity between the cracked and uncracked condition, we have prepared for crack condition also we have used m by capital bd square. Okay, and how we did this by in the expression of ast we use pt into capital d divided by 100. Instead of effective depth, we have used the capital D, so that the final expression will be in the form of m by b d square and not m by b d square. Okay, just to have the uniformity with the uncracked condition. So these are the curves which satisfy the uncracked condition. Okay, and whereas the earlier curves, they were the curve that satisfies the crack condition. Okay, so when you design, you have to make sure that your section satisfy both cracked as well as uncracked condition. So for that, the solution is the balanced solution. Okay, so balanced solution is nothing but it is obtained by superimposing both the curves. Say for example, for M25 and HYSD bar, this was the curve for the crack condition. Okay. These curves, these are the for the cracked condition. Okay. And these are the curves for the uncracked condition. Okay, so this portion, which is the intersection of the two, that is the balanced solution. Okay, so for different this d by d ratios and the value of pt, you can the intersection of the two curve will give you the balanced solution which satisfy both the condition, crack condition as well as uncrack condition. Okay, same way for the for M30 grid and HYSD bar, these are the curves for the crack condition, and these are the curves for the uncracked condition. Okay, and the intersection of the two is your balanced solution. Okay, these are the curves for various d by capital D ratio. This is also d by d ratio. This is x-axis is along pt, and this is m by bd square. So with this, we'll take one example. So just before that, let us write the balance. What is balance solution? So the values. This is nothing but the values satisfying both the crack as well as uncrack conditions gives balance solution. So These are the curve for the crack condition. And these are the curves for the uncracked condition, and the balance condition is the one obtained by superimposing the two curves. Let us superimpose this curve on the that, so you will get the balance solution. This is for the M25 grade. Okay. See, just superimpose these curves. Okay. These curves on these curves. So you will get the this solution, this balance curve solution for the curve for the balance solution. Okay. These are the crack condition. This is uncracked condition. This is for M25 and M30 grade of concrete. Okay, M30 and M25. And this is the balanced solution. For M25 grade of concrete, clear. So same way we can have the for the M30 grade also. So with this, let us solve an example. The data for the example is a rectangular section 250 mm wide by 545 mm effective depth with overall depth of 600 mm is reinforced with three numbers of 16 mm diameter bar in tension. Find out the moment of resistance of the section. The material are M30 grade of concrete and HYSD bars of grade Fe415. So write the data. Just wait for a few minutes. There is an issue with the pointer. Okay, so let us write the data. I think that is example two. We have been asked to design a rectangular section. Rectangular section of 250 mm wide and 545 mm effective depth and overall depth of 600 mm is reinforced with three numbers of 16 mm diameter bars intention. Okay, so we want to we have to find out the moment of resistance of section, the materials are M30 grade of concrete and Fe415 grade of steel. Okay, this thing is given to us. So let us try to find the moment of resistance. Given data, we have been given a rectangular section. The size of the section is 250 by, actually it is 600 mm, and we have been given the effective depth as 545 mm. Okay, so let us draw the section. So you have a section of 250 mm by 600 mm. Let us say this is the overall depth. D, that is 600 mm, and this is pi 40 pi, that is up to this. Let us say and it is reinforced with three bars of 16 mm diameter. Okay, this is your AST. And your AST is given to you as 3 of pi 16. So it is equal to 3 into area of 16 mm diameter is 201. So it will be 603 mm square. Okay. And you have been given M 30 grade of concrete. Okay. So concrete is M 30 and steel is Fe 415. So M 30 grade of concrete means the modular ratio of M 30 grade of concrete is 9.33. Then sigma CBC is 10 Newton per mm square. This you can get from the tables 1, 2, 3, and 4 given in IS 3370 part 2. And your sigma CBT, which is required for the uncracked condition, so that will be 2 Newton per mm square. Okay. So, and from the steel, the permissible stress in steel is sigma ST is equals to 130 Newton per mm square because it is HYSD bar. Okay, because HYSD bar. So this data has been given to you and we are supposed to find the moment resistance of the section. Okay, so to find the moment of resistance, let us first consider the cracked condition. So considering the crack condition, taking moments of transformed section or transformed areas about neutral axis. So the thing we have done while derivating the charts, same thing we have to repeat here. So we don't know the neutral axis. Let the neutral axis be at some location. Let it be x. Okay, this is our neutral axis. We know the width of the section. So width of the section is 250. So it will be b times x, this part, b into x, and moment of this part will be into x by 2. Into x by 2. Okay, and this has to be equal to the moment by the steel because this portion is ignored. Okay, here the concrete in tension zone is ignored. Concrete in tension zone is ignored because it is a crack condition. So it will be m times AST times this distance. So this distance is pi 45 minus x. So it, in general, it will be d effective depth minus x. So now substituting the values of b and effective depth d, so it will be therefore 250 into x square by 2 is equal to modular ratio is 9.33 times AST. The AST for here it is 603 times effective depth is 545 minus x. So here your b is 250 mm Your modular ratio is 9.33 and AST is 603 mm square and effective depth is 545 mm. So simplifying this, you will get the values of x. So x is around 135.72 mm. Okay, if you solve this quadratic equation, you will get two values of the x, and the one possible value and the another will be impossible. So this is the possible value which lies within our section. So with this, our depth of neutral axis depth of critical neutral axis depth of critical neutral axis that is xc. Okay, this is critical neutral axis xc is equal to kc times d, because we know that kc is nothing but xc by d. So you can write critical neutral axis depth is equals to kc times d, because kc is nothing but your neutral axis depth factor. So kc for this grade of concrete, so for M30, the value of kc is how much? If you remember from the above, the value of kc for M30 is 0.418. okay, so you can write directly 0.418. okay, or you can find it out from the by putting the values. So it will be 0.418 into d, that is 545. So this will be 227.81 mm. Now this is the maximum, this is nothing but your xu max. Okay, this is your xu max which you use in the limit state method. Okay, here we denote this by xc, that is critical neutral axis. So this value is greater than x, so that means your section is under reinforced section. Okay, so this implies that xc is greater than x, that is your section is under reinforced section. Okay, so if you just plot xc, then it is like this. This is your xc, which is 227.81 mm, and this value is 135.72 mm. Okay, so with this you can say that your section is under reinforced section. So the moment of resistance, of cracked section, it will be, let us say it is M crack is equal to sigma ST AST J into D. So sigma ST is 130, AST is 603, and J is nothing but your, if you remember this J is 1 minus K by 3. Okay, or it can be written as you can write JD is nothing but your D minus this x by 3, means k by kd by 3, both are the same. So here your JD will be let us plot the stress diagram. So this will be like this. This is your C and this is the T. This distance is called JD. Okay. Now, if this is X, then this will be the CG of the triangle, that is X/3. Okay. So your JD will be equal to the effective depth, that is this D minus X/3. So we write here JD is equals to D minus X/3. So that is pi 45 minus 135.72 by 2. Okay, so that is pi 45 minus 135.72 by 2. So you will get a moment of resistance M crack as 36.77 kilonewton meter. This is the moment of resistance for the
sir.
Yes
sir, over x shape by 3 आएगा सर, आपने 2 लिया आंसर 545 minus 135.1.
yes, 3 x by 3, it is x by 3. Okay, you substitute this value, you will get this only. So this is the cracked moment of inertia, crack moment of resistance. Okay, now next we'll find the uncracked moment of resistance. See, in the exam you cannot use the charts, so you have to follow this procedure only to find the cracked as well as uncracked moment, and the least of the two will be considered as the moment of resistance of the section, because we don't want the section to either fail in crack or uncrack. So the least of the two will be taken. So for the second case is the uncracked condition. So again, taking the moment of the section about the neutral axis. Taking moments of transformed section or transformed areas about the neutral axis. Transformed areas about neutral axis, it will be B into X into X/2. Let us draw the section. This AST now. This is 600. This is 545, and this is 250. So now let us say this is the neutral axis. the portion above the neutral axis, the formula will be b into x, that is b into, let us say this depth is x, that is the depth of the neutral axis. This x is nothing but your k into d, but we express now in form of x. So b into x by 2, okay, and this should be equal to the moment from the portion below the neutral axis. So that will be your b into, if the total depth is d, so it will be d minus x into d minus x by 2. Okay, so you can write as square by 2. So it will be d minus dx square by d minus x whole square by 2. Okay, this is due to the portion of the concrete plus this steel. So it will be m minus 1 into AST into the lever arm distance. So lever arm distance of this will be this is effective depth d, so it will be d minus x. So this will be d minus x. Okay, so now we know that the width is 250, so 250 into x square by 2 is equal to 250 into 600 minus x by 2, x volts, six volts square by 2 plus m is 9.33 minus 1 into AST is 603 into d, that is 45 minus x. So again, simplifying this, you will get the value of x. Okay, the value of x will be 307.94 mm. Okay, solving this quadratic equation, you will get the value of the x. Now let us find the see, you can see that the neutral axis is now shifted downward as against the cracked section, because now the concrete below the neutral axis is also effective. So your neutral axis will shift downward. So that is why the value of neutral axis is more compared to the cracked section. So next, find the moment of inertia about neutral axis. So Ixx is equal to, if you remember the formula, it was bd cube by 12 plus d into d into x minus d by 2 whole square. This was for the portion of the concrete plus the portion of the steel, that is m AST into d minus x whole square. The formula given in the book was in terms of k into d. Okay, it was in the form of k into d, but here x is nothing but your k into d. Okay, so we have replaced kd with the x. So the formulas are both the same. You can use the one given in the book, or you can use this formula. But here we have just modified the formula by just putting the value kd equals to x. So here it will be 250 into 600 cubed by 12 plus 250 into 600 into the x. X is now 307.94 minus 600 by 2 whole square. So 9.33 मॉड्यूलर रेशियो माइनस 1 इंटू ए एस टी दैट इज 603 इंटू दिस डी डी इज 545 माइनस एक्स दैट इज 307.94 होल स्क्वायर. ओके दिस इज द पोर्शन रजिस्टर्ड बाय द स्टील. ओके दिस इज स्टील एंड दिस इज कॉन्क्रीट. सो यू विल गेट IXX as 4.792 into 10 to the power 9 mm raised to 4. Okay, now your X value is how much? 307.94. Okay, so your this value we want to find, we have to check this stress at this level. So this distance will be 600 minus 307.94. So that is equal to 292.06. Okay, that is the soffit of the bottom from the neutral axis. Soffit of the beam from the neutral axis. So your moment of resistance of uncracked section call this as uncrack, M uncrack is equal to see the formula was, if you remember, it was M by I is equal to sigma by Y. We want to find at the level of the bottom of the beam, so M stress at that level is sigma C B T, and the Y distance at that level, that is YB, bottom of the beam, and this, so we can transform this M uncrack is equals to sigma C B T. Sigma CBT divided by YB into IXX. So what is sigma CBC CBT? If you remember in the data, it is given to you that it is M30 grade. So for M30 grade, the sigma CBT value is 2 Newton per mm square. So you substitute here 2 into this I value, that is 4.792 into 10 to the power 9 volt divided by YB. Now YB is this value. This is your YB. That is the depth of the extreme fiber in the bottom of the beam to the neutral axis. So it will be 292.06. So this comes out to be 32.82 kilonewton meter. So you are therefore uncracked moment is 32.82 kilonewton meter. Now the moment of resistance of the section will be the minimum of the two. Therefore moment of resistance of section is equal to minimum of M crack and M uncrack. Okay, so it is the minimum of M crack. M crack value is how much? It is 36.77 or 32.82. Okay, so it is 32.82 kilonewton meter. This is the moment of resistance of the section, MR of section, moment of resistance of section. Okay, so you have to check both crack as well as uncrack, because your section sometimes your section may govern in uncrack condition or it may govern in crack condition. So you have to check both, and the minimum of that will be your moment of resistance. Okay, so you can do one thing. See here, if we can write a note here. So we can say if the depth provided is greater or is larger than that required for balance condition, then the strength design will be governed. Okay, in that case strength design will govern. Okay, and if the depth provided is lesser than that required required for balance condition, then uncracked design will govern. Hello, am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, okay. So this way you can design the section under bending only. Okay. So these two things you need to keep in mind. If the depth provided for the section is more than the balance required for the balance section, then this crack design will govern, means crack strength means crack design will govern, and if the depth provided is less, then uncracked design will govern. Okay, so with this this part is over, and one more topic is, okay, so let us quickly see the second example which is given in the textbook. a wall of water tank is 250 mm thick, is reinforced in tension with 16 mm diameter at 200 mm center to center. Okay, so the section is 250 mm thick. Okay, this is 250 mm thick, and it is reinforced with the bars of 16 mm diameter. So they are 16 mm diameter, and the spacing between them is 200 center to center. Okay, that is this. Find the moment of resistance of the section for 1 meter width. Okay, so earlier was the beam example. Now here it is a slab type example, slab, or we can say raft or a wall type example. So here it is a wall. Okay, so we have to find the moment of resistance for 1 meter width of the section. Okay, the grade is M30 same, and Fe415 grade of steel, they are same. So for water retaining structure, the exposure here the effective depth is not given, so you have to assume the effective depth. So for that, let us say the exposure condition is severe. So for severe condition, the clear cover is 45 mm. So effective depth will be 250 minus 45 and half the bar diameter. So it will be this is your effective depth. Okay, so first we'll find the crack from the crack condition. So again, taking the moment of the area above the neutral axis. So above the neutral axis, it will be, see, the formula was B into X into X, B into X into X by 2, which this should be equal to this M AST into D minus X. So here width is 1000 mm. So 1000 into X square by 2 is equal to here M30 grade and HYSD. So modulus ratio is 9.33 into AST. So here it is given as 16 mm diameter, 200 center to center. So phi 16 mm at the rate 200 mm center to center means AST is equals to 16 mm diameter bar, area of 16 mm bar is 201 into 1000 divided by the spacing, that is 200. So it will be 5, so it will be 1005 mm square. So you substitute here AST, this is the AST for 16 mm bar at 200 center to center. So 1005 into your effective depth is 197, that is this value, minus X. So you again solve this in terms of X, you will get a quadratic equation, and substituting and solving that, you will get the value of X, that is see, this is the quadratic equation, X square plus 18.75X minus 3694 equals to 0. So solving this, you will get the value of X as 52.53. So your X is 52.53 mm. So then we find the critical depth of neutral axis. So critical depth of neutral axis is 0.481. This is for the see, XC is equals to KC into D. Now KC is 0.418. If you remember from the previous this example, it was 0.418 for M30 grade into your effective depth, that is 197. So it is 82.35. So again, X is less than X. So this means your section is under reinforced section. Okay, the section is under reinforced section. So you can find the moment of resistance. M is equals to AST sigma ST J into D. So your J into D is nothing but D minus X by 3. See, this is your section. Okay, this is your section of 1 meter width, and this is the is the neutral axis. Okay, so J into D will be the CG of this to this distance. So this CG will be, this CG will be your x by 3. So this distance will be d effective depth minus x by 3. So that is why it is JD. This JD is nothing but JD is x minus d minus x by 3. So AST is 1005, AST sigma ST is 130, d is effective depth, that is 197, and this x value is okay. This has to be, this is wrong actually. This has to be, your x has to be this value, that is 52.53. Okay, so this will now change. You can just check it. Just find it out. How much is this? 1005 into 130 into 197 minus 52.53 by 3. Okay, so that is this, multiply by 1005 multiply by 130 and divided by 10 to the power 6. So it will be 23.54. Okay, instead of this, it will be okay, kilo Newton meter. Okay. Because this is the this is not the moment of resistance of the under reinforced section. This is for the balance condition. When you use this XC here, that means this is the maximum moment of resistance the section can have with this amount of steel. So here it is 23.45. Then for the uncracked theory, again for uncracked theory, the equation will be B into x square by 2, which is equal to B into D minus x whole square by 2 plus M minus 1 into AST into D minus x whole square. Okay, so you substitute these values here. B is 1000, x is unknown, and B is 1000, D is 250. So like you all substitute all these values, you will get the value of x. Here it is 127. So your D minus x, which is nothing but your YT, okay, YB, which we use for the stress from the bottom. Okay, this value is nothing but your YB. So this YB is 122.67, and your IXX you can find it out using B D cube by 12 plus B into D into this X minus D by 2 whole square. This is for the concrete part, and for the steel part it is M minus 1 into AST into this D minus X whole square. So substitute these values, you will get the value of I, and your moment of resistance will be I moment of resistance M by I is equals to sigma by Y. So here you are checking the stresses at the bottom. So sigma CBT divided by YB, and you might take this I to the right. So it will be this. So you substitute these values, you will get the moment of resistance is 21.91. Okay, so the minimum of the two value is 21.92. So your moment of resistance for this is this value. Okay, so this was 23.45 kilonewton meter. If we keep this, then also this is more. Okay, so moment of resistance is the minimum of M crack and M uncrack. So that is minimum of 23.45 and 21.91. So that is 21.91 kilonewton meter. Clear? So any doubt in this? So similarly, then another example, I hope you can try this of your own. It will be in the same line of action, but here you have to design the section. Instead of the earlier two examples, they were for the to find the moment of resistance of the section, means it was the analysis problem. Now it is a design problem, means you have to arrive at some depth of the section. Okay, and then find the capacity of that section, and if that satisfies the given load, then it is okay. So in the earlier example, you have been given the cross section. So in the first example, the cross section was 250 by 600. Okay, in the second example, it was 1 meter width by 250 mm thick. Okay, but here there is no cross section given to you. You have been given the bending moment directly, or you may be given the load, so you, from that you have to find out the bending moment. But here the direct bending moment is given, so no need to find the bending moment. Directly moment is given. Otherwise, sometimes you may be given the load. Let us say it is loaded with 25 kilonewton per meter UDL, so you find out the bending moment, and then from the bending moment you arrive at some depth of the section. Okay, or you decide some depth of the section, and from that you find the moment of resistance for the cracked theory as well as for the uncracked theory, and the least of the two will be your moment of resistance of the section. And this moment of resistance should be, you have to ensure that moment of resistance of the section is greater than this moment, bending moment. Okay, so if this is satisfied, then whatever the section you have chosen, that is 300 mm depth, that is okay. Otherwise you have to revise the design. This is how you can solve this example. Clear? So with this, your first chapter of this, see one more example is there. Here also, so here you have been asked to reduce the depth. See, it is in the same line of action of example 4. Wherein you consider the depth as, you consider this depth as 300 mm. Okay, you consider depth as 300 mm. But now in the example 5, it is been said that you consider the depth as 290 mm. Okay, instead of 300 mm, you consider the depth as 290 mm. And find the the amount of the steel. Okay, and find the steel for the flexure and comment. So I hope that you can solve this. They are in the same direction we have done in the earlier examples. Okay, so with this, one more topic is there. Now we have seen the members subjected to tension only, and we have seen the sections subjected to bending only. Now what what happens when the sections are subjected to both tension as well as bending, because in actual design the sections are usually subjected to combined actions of axial tension as well as bending moment. So in that cases you have to make sure that it satisfies this interaction formula, that is sigma ct by fct by sigma ct plus fcbt divided by sigma cbt should be less than 1, where fct is the stresses, tensile stresses. This is tensile stresses, okay, and this is the permissible tensile stresses in concrete. Permissible tensile stress. This is bending stress, tension due to bending stress, tension in concrete, tensile stresses in concrete. Tensile stresses in concrete due to bending tension, and this is the permissible value of the permissible stresses in concrete due to bending tension. And if this ratio is less than 1, then your design is okay. So in the next class we will cover these members, members subjected to combined axial tension and bending moment. So we stop here. If you have any doubt, then we can discuss now. Actually, today my laptop was crashed. It was not working. So I have to switch to another laptop. So that is why there was an audio and video issue, because in this laptop I don't have any webcam. So I have to record for video. I have to attach one mobile phone, and for audio also I have to attach another mobile phone. So with two mobile phones and a laptop, this class has been conducted. So any doubt in this?